Can't tell you how glad I am to have you back home.
It's good to be back, Mum.
Oi.
What do you think you were doing last night?
Nothing.
Don't give me all that. Mum's told me all about it.
All about what?
About staying out till all hours. About what Nigel said. About you messing up your jacket so you can look like one of that gang.
Why does everyone keep going on about him?
He has promised not to see them again.
Have you?
And he has got loads of nice friends, haven't you?
Yeah, well, I better tell them to watch what they wear, hadn't I? In case they wear the same things and get mistaken for criminals.
Right, it's enough of that. Go on, upstairs, finish getting ready for school.
Did you admit it?
No. Do you not think we're being a bit hard on him?
I don't know, Mum.
I think you're being perfectly reasonable.
Believe it, not Marty.
Well, I can't believe that Nigel would make that sort of mistake.
Look, Mum, supposing it was him. If a little bit of graffiti is the worst he's ever going to do, then surely it's not the end of the world, is it?
Well, it depends if it leads to other things, though, doesn't it?
Was not Marty.
Let her calm down. She'll be all right.
OK, OK. But how many more times are we going to have this conversation with Pauline?
What are you doing?
Trying to get this mug off your jacket.
She'll go that to me, not you. Can't I do anything that doesn't get interfered with? What is it, Meryl?
No. I only suppose it matters if you were lying to me, if you've got no intention of keeping your promise.
I wasn't lying.
I doubt if it would come off anyway.
Can I have it back, please? Thanks.
Oi!
It'd be tactful if you come straight up and talk tonight.
Yeah, all right.
All right. I'll see you later.
Bye-bye.